Show where we're gonna be having discussions
and suffering absolutely no repercussions. This practice show starts right now.
Hello, tech crew inside the control room. I'm Jazzy Jenica.
And I am Just Sitting Jenny. Let's begin with some readers. I'm Jenica now.
Square Enix has announced that it will be ending service to the team action RPG game Dragon Quest, The Adventure of Dai. The heroes bond on April 26th. That's my sister's birthday. The game was first launched on September 27, 2021, but due to difficulties and practicalities of delivering the same standard of play since the initial launch, the decision was made to end the game. Square Enix stated that several updates will be made to the game, including the final chapters of Dragon Tracks and Bonding Journey. Anthony noticed that Journey was misspelled on the website and also did not know how to conclude this reader. Thanks, Anthony.
I think he didn't know how to conclude it because one of the requirements to go to Kent State is not being able to read.
That's so true, Jenny.
I know. That's how I got in. Squanch Games tweeted out that they have received Justin Roiland's resignation. Justin Roiland is one of the creators of the hit television sitcom Rick and Morty, but Roiland was recently accused of domestic abuse. Roiland voice acts in Squanch Games' High on Life, and with his resignation, Squanch Games hopes that fans will continue to support the game and be awesome.
Guys, Niall Horan is dropping a new single? In a post on his Instagram, Horan announced that he will be releasing a new single entitled Heaven on April 17th. The post included Horan dressed in a button-down denim sitting in front of a drum kit. While Horan did not give any more information on the new single, fans are hyped for its release. And I am not one of them.
I am.
Listen to them.
I'm still hoping for One Direction to get back together.
So valid. Fall Out Boy is, though. Slash Jen.
The marching band world was shocked when Drum Corps' international group, the Santa Clara Vanguard, announced they will not be competing in the 2023 season. Staff members at Santa Clara Vanguard stated that due to a number of financial reasons, such as growing costs for touring, smaller bingo profits, and miscalculations in predicting post-COVID DCI, the group would not compete. SCV was DCI's world champion in 2018 with their show entitled Babylon, and is usually a consistent top five contender in recent years. It's a shame that they will not compete, and the community hopes that they'll make a strong return in 2024.
So fair, and you know it's Anthony making this show because we're talking about, what's that? Chess!
Woo!
The Tata Steel Chess Tournament 2023 wraps up today as round 13 play begins. The event includes big chess names such as Magnus Carlsen, Ding Liren, Richard Rapport, and Anish Giri. I really hope that I pronounced all of those names correctly, but I probably didn't. This reader is over. Checkmate.
Imagine getting your credit card information leaked online by a fish. It may sound absurd, but it really did happen to YouTuber Mutakimakar. I can't speak. Yeah, they were streaming his fish playing Pokemon by motion tracking the fish and setting up buttons that would correspond to the fish's position in the tank. However, when the game crashed, the fish opened up the Nintendo store, purchasing items and leaking their credit card information. You could say this was not a sophisticated move by Mutakimaru.
Oh, I see what you did there. But coming up, we'll be talking about Muppets.
Which are definitely not talking puppets.
There's a difference.
The Tech Practice Show. We'll be right back.
Welcome back. Here at All Systems Blurbgenda, we've got only one question for the tech booth. Are you a man or are you a Muppet? So, here on the couch, we got some pretty funky folk, and we're here to talk about the Muppets. something that I didn't come up with last minute. You know, last night or this morning. I don't really know. What was that? Cool, cool, cool. Anyways, so what's you guys' experience with the Muppets? I definitely know little to nothing about them and am a normal amount of a fan of the Muppets. How about y'all?
Various movies, like I really like the Christmas Carol and like Great Muppet Caper, and the one from like 2011, and like the sequel.
Is that Most Wanted?
No, that's the movie before Most Wanted.
The Muppet.
The Muppets
the
movie.
The one that's like, called The Muppets.
Okay. Like just The Muppets.
I've only seen that one, and I watch the Muppets Christmas Carol every year.
Yeah, that's right.
It's my go-to Christmas Carol movie.
It's good. It's always been a staple for me personally.
Who among us do you think I'm talking?
Hey dog, are you the discussion panel host?
Who among us is
without sin
is most like the most radiates live action guy in Muppets movies?
Rocco.
Yeah, I was gonna say probably me.
Yeah. You're just the Muppet in the Muppet movies.
Thank you.
They can be both. I guess now they are both.
That's true. Can be both. Joe, what's your Muppet experience?
Muppets.
Fair enough.
I get that.
Did you guys know, actually, that Muppet Christmas Carol is the most accurate Muppet Christmas Carol interpretation, movie interpretation, of all of them that have been made so far?
Whoa.
Mickey's Christmas Carol is more accurate, that's all I'm going to say.
No, genuinely, literally, it's the most accurate to the book.
What about the terrifying one from, 2004?
Nope, The Muppets was more accurate than that. That's just cool. A fun little side bit, as well as the costuming for that movie was very accurate to the times. It's one of the most accurate to the times costuming movies. Movies with the costuming for movies all around. Now, I came up with very good questions for this panel, as you can tell, so I'm going to start things off a little bit with a bit of a maybe controversial take.
I had a question I do.
What's your? I was just going to start with a controversial maybe take.
Go for it.
I think Walter from the Muppets is completely unnecessary to the Muppet canon, and I think he is essentially just a self-insert character, like in a bad fan fiction.
Who is Walter?
What do you guys
the
think
guy
of that?
The Muppets.
Man
or Muppet. Man
or Muppet guy.
Walter.
I mean, I feel like you could do the same thing with Scooter. I feel like they kind of fit the same role, but I feel like it's a talk. We haven't seen, when was the last time we've seen Walter?
Right.
In Muppets Most Wanted. He played an integral role in Muppets Most Wanted.
That's right.
He was the only one other than Animal to actually notice that Kermit was missing, even though the rest of the Muppets have been around Kermit for the past, 70 years.
I forgot about that guy. Yeah, he's pretty dumb.
He feels like a forced character.
Again, when was the last time we've seen him? So I guess when was the last time we've seen the Muppets?
Yeah.
I guess by connection, yeah. He would have been good for that one Muppets sitcom show.
He should be like the character.
That's called just the Muppets or whatever.
The character they introduce, hey, it's a new guy, but then the gag is they kill him off immediately.
like Kenny from South Park?
No.
That will be the plot in Muppets Knives Out.
That
will be the plot in Muppets Knives Out.
I'm hyped for Muppets Knives Out.
Yeah, that's right. I did hear about that.
Muppets. Well, it's not happening.
Well, it's not happening, but.
But it would be cool. We can just pretend it's happening. I'm really hyped for that movie.
Jenica, do you think LeBlanc should be a Muppet, or the culprit should just be the only human?
I think LeBlanc should be the only human in a cast of entirely Muppets. Obviously, look at that man.
But I want a LeBlanc Muppet.
That would be very cool. However, look at that man.
Can you imagine Blanc as a Muppet?
Benoit LeBlanc.
It's just Benoit Blanc.
Is it?
Yes.
I thought it was Benoit the Black.
Nope.
Huh.
I know what's going on.
I'm gonna keep calling him LeBlanc.
I want to see a Muppets Die Hard interpretation.
What do you guys think would be the most interesting movie to feature a cast of all Muppets, one human? Tell us which character is the human. We'll go from Nick all the way down.
Final Destination.
Who's the human?
Whoever lives.
I was going to say Twilight and have just Bella be the only human.
I was hoping for Edward.
Anthony's telling you to rap. That or he's making a sick dance move.
I'm going to assume that Anthony wants us to rap if I could get a big thumbs up from him, if that's true. He's walking away instead. That's cool. That's cool. But unfortunately, that's all the time we have for this riveting, well thought out discussion that was planned many years in advance. After the break, members will be competing to see who knows their geography. Not me.
Hello and welcome to Guess the Country, where our contestants will try to guess the country based on the outline. I'm your host, Eric Watts, and today's contestants include Rocco, Enrique, Jenny, and Kyle. Without further ado, let's get into the countries.
Germany.
Kyle said it. Yes, that's right. I thought it would be like a behind them.
Okay.
Yeah, raise your hands. And Kyle gets, he loses a point because he didn't raise his hand. So 0 points for him. Next one. Kyle?
Spain.
Wrong, you lose a point.
Darn.
Kyle?
Portugal.
Wrong. Kyle, can someone else guess? Okay, Kyle.
France.
No!
That's not
France. I'm going to free ball and say Ecuador.
No. Jenny?
Ohio. I'm
you lose 2 points.
I'm so funny.
Anyone? Rike, you
I'm going to eyeball it. I'm going to go Turkey.
No.
Shit.
Kyle, your last one.
Ohio, too.
Shut up. You lose 3 points.
Ohio spelled backwards is Ohio.
No, it isn't. Okay, we're skipping. We're going past this one. It was Vuvuzela in Venezuela. Next country. Raise your hand, Rocco, if you have.
I'm gonna say Croatia.
No. Kyle.
Spain.
No.
I don't know what like any other country looks like. So.
Did we say Ohio yet?
This should have been a British show. Okay, that was Belgium. We're going to the next one.
I was gonna guess Belgium, but I'm also kind of dumb.
Why didn't you get, you don't
Because I don't know what it looks like. That was just a guess.
All right, next one.
That's what? A country?
Jenny?
Sagandis?
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
Okay, who made the map and why is he not fired?
No guesses. Nothing?
This is a country?
Yes, this is a country.
Are you sure?
Yes, I'm sure. I don't know. Anthony made this. So maybe it isn't a country. Maybe we're both liars.
Alaska.
This one was Panama. Moving on.
Forgot that was a country. I thought that was a city.
Why don't you think Panama was a city? Kyle?
China.
That was an actual guess, so you got a point for that.
But it wasn't China?
It wasn't China. Kyle.
Mongolia.
No.
Damn it.
No bad words. Enrique.
Russia?
No.
Okay, never mind. I was going to guess
he
Russia.
Just said no bad words.
My bad.
No other words? No other guesses?
I'm really bad at geography.
Same.
I'm really bad at geography.
It was Bulgaria. Oh. Next one up. Kyle?
Greenland.
No.
Anthony, say it. What is it? What? It's not
Greenland. Cam's been hitting the ding this entire time. Any other guesses?
Anthony, what is it?
I haven't
me.
Heard a ding, so.
It's not Guatemala either. The tech loses a point.
Oh.
Kyle?
Guam.
No. I figured this one would be the easiest one.
Starts with a G.
You guys can't guess a single G country?
I guessed two.
Okay, yeah, you get the two. You got two.
The
no,
United
none other.
States of America?
Oh, my. Moving on. It was Greece. Greece.
Oh, my God.
Next one up.
I always said that.
I forgot that's a country.
Didn't give me enough time. I'm going to say New Zealand.
Yes, actually. You get like 3 points.
That looks
that's
like
the only one everyone got it right so far. Next up.
Is that New Zealand?
Is that New Zealand?
Oh, wrong one.
New Zealand.
Everyone gets a point.
Yeah! Woo! Woo!
Doesn't mean anything if everyone gets one, but bowl, guys.
Utah? No. It's a square.
You lose the point you just lost.
It's a...
You lose the point you just
lost. Tell me. Anthony, mouth it out.
Anthony, don't help her.
Do it in sign language. Finger spell it. Please help me.
You're back to 0 points because you really wanted help. You wanted sheep. Any other guesses?
That's not Ohio.
It's definitely not Canada.
It's not Canada.
Egypt?
Yes.
Okay.
Get like 5 points. Next up.
That was the first one.
Germany.
No.
That was the first one.
Oh. New Zealand?
Is this the newest one? Yeah, it's the newest one.
Okay, that's a different one.
I'll give you a hint. It sounds like a famous artist. And like rapper artist, not like artist.
Drake.
No. No, what country sounds like Drake?
Starts with an L.
No.
Doesn't start with an L. It starts with a K.
Oh god.
I'm so smart. Kenya?
Yes.
Oh, I kind of. Oh.
Okay. Yeah. I'm so awesome. I would have said that.
This is our last one.
Okay.
Where is it? Keeps going away.
Actually, don't know.
That's Kenya
that is,
again.
That is. That actually don't know how to pronounce this one. This is the last one. Yo, who's hitting the wrong button?
I'm just going to say a fun one. Equatorial Guinea.
No, but I never heard of this country before now, so.
The DRC.
Which continent is it in?
Dude, I just said I've never heard of it before now. Why would I know?
I'd like to buy a vowel.
Is it Asia?
Okay.
Is it Thailand?
No.
I don't know.
One word?
Yes, one word.
Nepal?
No. Starts with an... I'll give the M through... Wait.
What?
Never mind. Forget it. Forget that hint. It starts with an L.
Starts with an L.
Huh?
Laos.
Yes.
Oh, wow.
I'm assuming that's how it's pronounced.
I'm so stupid.
That's it. Let's see who won.
Not me.
The winner is...
Anthony. Anthony's the winner.
Yeah, Anthony wins. And the winner is Anthony. We're just going with that.
Yeah.
And maybe Kyle, because he actually got most of these, like, a couple of them right. After the break, we'll be putting on a show to make you laugh.
I got 10.
Here today, we have a guest who's been making headlines recently. Please welcome Mr. Joe Finch, divorce attorney and used car salesman. He should be here any minute now. Thank you for joining us, Mr. Finch. So Mr. Finch.
Please stop calling me Mr. Finch. It makes me feel old.
Sorry. Should I call you Joe or something? Like, do you prefer something else?
Oh my god, just ask the questions already.
Recently, there was footage that seemingly exposed you. People were calling you a fraud, a scammer, a con man. One person even called you Joe Finch divorce conner.
Earthquake!
Broken car salesman, what do you have to say about that?
You don't get to my level without making a couple enemies. People are going to say a lot of false things about you. Price of fame.
Price of fame?
Yeah, the price of fame. I'm a worldwide phenomenon. I'm like today's Cristiano Ronaldo.
He's still alive.
Shut up.
Okay, sorry, but just one thing. If you're a worldwide phenomenon, then why are your commercials so cringe?
Cringe? You think those are cringe? Quentin wishes he could make something as good as my commercials. Now, don't get me wrong. I love Pulp Fiction, especially the part where he says, yippee-ki-yay, melon farmer, and then kills the gimp suit dude, and went through time travel, and they find out he was dead the entire time. But my commercials are impeccable. Could they be better? Yeah, but I blame my ex-wife for that.
What?
Yeah, you heard me, Jill. I blame you for this. Conspiring against me, taking the house, the money, my car, taking the kids. I blame you for all of it.
Wait, Jill Biden?
You have kids?
She took Rickolas and Billiam from
me. Rickolas and Billiam?
Do you know how humiliating it is to buy your own cars? Everyone at the dealership has been laughing at me.
So let me get this straight. You and Jill Biden named your kids Rickolas and Billiam.
I've been having to sleep in my office for the past 3 weeks, and the $12,000 designer luxury couch I have is the most uncomfortable thing I have ever touched.
A $12,000 couch.
All I've ever wanted to do was impress my stepdad, but he still screws up my name. It's been 12 years and you still call me Jeff. And now you're my ex-wife's attorney in this case?
He's working for her?
You think that since I'm a divorce attorney, they'd let me defend myself, right? Nope, apparently I'm too mentally unstable, so they assigned me some bum that walked into the courtroom in a leather jacket was talking about grints, thinking he was Vinnie Gambini. You'll never be Vinnie Gambini.
Oh, that's the Karate Kid.
Yeah. One's from like the 80s, not the 2010 remake, which everyone trashes on, but I honestly thought was like pretty good. The real problem with it though is it wasn't about karate, it was about kung fu. So they should have called it not Karate Kid, but like Kung Fu Kid.
Anyway, so we're getting off track. Let's bring it back a bit. Why don't they let you defend yourself in court?
They treat me like a joke. Everyone's been treating me like a joke. Ever since I got slapped on TV and went viral, everyone's been making memes about it, making remixes, using the sound of the slap. Someone did a cover of You Belong With Me by Taylor Swift. It has over 32 million views. I love Taylor Swift, but I can't listen to her now because of it.
Well, that's a slap in the face. I was making... It was a G.I. Jane joke!
Watching SNL from now on.
Hopefully he won't be right back.
And that will conclude the Tech Entertainment Practice Show. Remember to tip your servers.
And to hold the door open for everyone.
Bye! Bye.